ever realized that everyone trades? For example, when you go to university, you pay fee and the university gives you their service. It is one example of trading. The question is that, why do people trade? The most simple answer is because everyone has different skills and strengths. So each people will specialize in one thing and trade with the other people for things they need. So do countries. Every country doesn't produce everything by themselves, but they produce goods that they are good at and purchase the other goods from other countries. A person or a country should produce goods or service if they have comparative advantage of that goods or services over another. What is comparative advantage? To make you understand better, let's see this following illustration. Suppose there are only two countries, United States and also Japan, and there are only two goods, cars and computers. The data shows that United States can produce either 10 cars or 20 computers in an hour. It means if United States use all the time to produce car, United States can produce 10 cars. Well, if United States use all the time to produce computer, United States can produce 20 computers. How about Japan? Japan can produce 8 cars or 10 computers in an hour. It means if Japan use all the time to produce car, Japan can produce 8 cars. Well, if Japan use all the time to produce computer, Japan can produce 10 computers. There is a term we call as absolute advantage. Absolute advantage is the ability of individual, company, or region to produce greater quantity of a good or service per unit of time, or to produce quicker per unit goods or services produced. One more time, absolute advantage is the ability of individual, company, or region to produce greater quantity of good or service per unit of time, or to produce quicker per unit goods or services produced. In this case, as you can see, that USA can produce more car than Japan. USA can produce 10 cars in an hour, while Japan can produce 8 cars in 1 hour. So USA has absolute advantage in producing cars. How about the computer? USA also can produce more computers than Japan. USA can produce 20 computers, while Japan only 10 computers in 1 hour. So USA also has absolute advantage in producing computers. So USA has absolute advantage of producing both cars and computers. Do you get this idea? The question is, does it mean that USA has to produce both goods, cars and computers, while Japan has to import both goods, cars and computer from USA? Not necessarily. Who need to produce the goods is a person or a region or a country that has comparative advantage, not absolute advantage. One more time, who need to produce the goods is a person or a country or a region that has comparative advantage, not absolute advantage. What is comparative advantage then? Comparative advantage is economic ability to produce a particular good or service at lower opportunity cost than its trading partner. One more time, comparative advantage is economy ability to produce a particular good or service at lower opportunity cost than its trading partner. Opportunity cost is what you have to give up because you choose another best alternatives. For example, today actually you can work and get salary $100. If you decide to hang out with your friend instead of working, of course you will not get this $100 because you don't work. So the salary $100 is your opportunity cost. Because $100 is what you have to give up because you choose to hang out with your friend. Is it clear, right? Now let's go back to the case. We have to find the opportunity cost of producing each product for each country. How to find the opportunity cost? Let's follow my instruction. As mentioned here that USA can produce 10 cars or 20 computers in an hour. Remember that it is or. If USA use all the time to produce cars, it means they have to sacrifice 20 computers. If USA use all the time to produce cars, USA will produce 10 cars. But USA has to sacrifice 20 computers. So producing 10 cars equal to sacrificing 20 computers. So to produce one car, USA has to sacrifice 2 computers. It means the opportunity cost to produce a car is 2 computers. Do you get the idea? Now, simple formula. Opportunity cost equals to number of other goods sacrifice divided by number of goods produced. One more time, number of other goods sacrifice divided by number of goods produced. In this case, number of other goods sacrifice, it is 20 computers divided by number of goods produced, it is 10 cars. So opportunity cost will be 2 computers per car. Or in one car, USA has to sacrifice 2 computers. Now, if USA use all the time to produce computer, so USA can produce 20 computers. It means they has to sacrifice to produce 10 cars. So to produce one computer, USA has to sacrifice 10 cars divided by 20 computers. It equals to half cars per computers. So opportunity cost to produce one computer is half cars. Do you get the point? Now Japan. If Japan produces 8 cars, Japan has to sacrifice 10 computers. So the opportunity cost equals to 10 computers that Japan sacrifice divided by 8 cars. So it equals to 1.25 computer per car. It means opportunity cost of producing one car for Japan equals to 1.25 computer. Now, if Japan use all the time to produce the computer, Japan has to sacrifice 8 cars. So the opportunity cost of producing computer for Japan equals to 8 cars that Japan sacrifice divided by 10 computers. It equals to 0.8 car per computer. So the opportunity cost of producing a computer for Japan is 0.8 car. And this is the recap of the opportunity cost. As mentioned before, that comparative advantage is economy ability to produce a particular good or service at a lower opportunity cost than its trading partner. For car here, Japan has lower opportunity cost. You can see that to produce a car, Japan has to sacrifice 1.25 computer, while USA has to sacrifice 2 computers. It means Japan has lower opportunity cost. Therefore, Japan has comparative advantage to produce cars. How about computer? USA here has lower opportunity costs. To produce computer, USA has to sacrifice only 0.5 car, while Japan has to sacrifice 0.8 car. It means USA has comparative advantage to produce computer. Therefore, Japan is better to produce car, while USA is better to produce computer. This we call as specialization. Specialization makes a country produce goods or services with lower opportunity costs. So there will be more products or services produced in the market. Is it clear, right? Let's go on. From this table, we can make a graph. The x-axis is cars and the y-axis is computer. Let's try to draw a graph for USA. USA can produce 10 cars or 20 computers in an hour. So if USA produce 10 cars, USA will not produce any computer. And if USA produce 20 computers, USA will not produce any car. For this learning, assume first that the curve is straight line. Though in the real life, it is not 100% straight line. It is downward sloping. Okay, the curve will be like this. When 10 cars produce, there will be no computer produce. When 20 computers produce, there will be no car produce. This graph is called as production possibility frontier. One more time, production possibility frontier, or PPF. PPF is a graph that describes the maximum amount of one good that can be produced for every possible level of production of another good. One more time, PPF is a graph that describes the maximum amount of one good that can be produced of every possible level of production of another good. In this case, is computer and also car. All combination of cars and computer that is in PPF line is efficient. So, USA can produce 0 car and 20 computers, or 2 cars and 16 computers, or 4 cars and 12 computers, or 6 cars and 8 computers, or 8 cars and 4 computers, or 10 cars with no computer. Because all those combination is in production possibility frontier. G point is below the line. It is inefficient point. USA can produce in G point, but it is not efficient. It means that the country doesn't use the resources as maximum as it can to produce goods or services. How about 8th point? 8th point is above the line. It is unattainable point. It is impossible for USA to produce combination of car and computer above the line. In this case, it is impossible for USA to produce 4 cars and 16 computers. It happens because of lack of resources, or we call it as scarcity. Do you get the idea, right? As conclusion that everyone or every country will always trade. Why? Because they will produce goods or services in which they have comparative advantage. By having this specialization, there will be more products produced in the market.